it's Michelle from Lab Muffin Beauty Science, chemistry PhD, and fan of makeup. I'm not all that experienced with makeup, even though I do really enjoy playing with it. But I've had a lot of people ask me to do a video about the science behind makeup products. I am by no means an expert on makeup, but I do find the science behind it really interesting. So here is foundation compatibility. If you like this sort of video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and click the notification bell. You might have had the experience where you're doing your makeup in the morning, and you put on your sunscreen or primer or moisturizer, and then you put your foundation on top. And then a few hours later, you look in the mirror, and your foundation is all speckly, like you're a pointillist painting or something. You probably didn't bring your foundation out with you, and so you can't really fix it, and so you're just stuck spending the rest of the day hanging out with only really short-sighted people. This is foundation incompatibility, or foundation clumping. So here we have freshly applied foundation. It's pretty even. Zoomed in, it's going to be a lot less even, but if you look at it from a distance, from a normal person distance, it looks even. And over here we have the clumped up foundation. You can see that the pigments started to bunch together, and you can see the bare skin poking through in a few bits. What exactly is happening, and what can you do to avoid it? Let's talk about the science behind foundation. What exactly is a foundation? I mean, what exactly is it? Most products in skincare and makeup are emulsions, and foundation is one of them. An emulsion contains two substances that don't really mix together, like oil and water. If you shake oil and water together, they separate after a while. But if you add an emulsifier or a surfactant, a chemical that likes both water and oil, the two will be forced to hang out, like if you have two friends who don't really like each other, but they both come to your birthday party. They'll put up with it because you're there keeping them both happy. To make an emulsion, you have to put in energy. To make an unstable emulsion, you just shake the two together, like oil and vinegar. If you want to make a stable emulsion, like a mayonnaise, you can use something like a food processor to mix the oil and vinegar with the egg acting as the emulsifier. Just like the mayonnaise, a foundation has its two liquid phases mixed together with an emulsifier in an industrial mixer. If we zoom into the foundation, microscopically, you can see that there are droplets of one liquid dispersed in the other. The liquid in the droplets is called the inner phase, and the liquid around it is the outer phase. The emulsifier sits in between them, pinning them together and stopping them from separating. My mayonnaise here is an oil in water emulsion. That means there are oil droplets sitting in the water. Oil is the inner phase, and water is the outer phase. Foundations are usually designed so that the skin color pigment is mostly in the outer phase, and so when you spread it on your skin, it goes on smoothly, rather than in little droplety dots. Historically, the first emulsions used in foundations were both oil in water and water in oil. But in the past 20 years or so, a special kind of liquid called silicones became much more popular. Silicones don't mix with water, and they don't always mix with oil either. Silicones are special because they're really, really slippery. And so when they're used as the outer phase of a foundation, they help us spread evenly across skin without caking or requiring a lot of skill on your part. So even someone like me who's not that great at makeup, especially before 9 a.m, I can still apply it without looking like an abstract painting at the end. Silicones are also really good at forming flexible films that last for a long time on your skin, and so this meant that cosmetic formulators could make long-wear foundations. On top of these benefits, silicones also don't feel greasy, and because they're not technically oils, and oils have a bad rep for acne-prone skin, so foundations can use silicones and call themselves oil-free, which is great for marketing, which is the real reason anyone does anything in the beauty industry. And so because of all of these advantages, water in silicone foundations are now more than 90% of all liquid foundations you'll come across. So armed with this knowledge, what can we work out about foundation clumping and how to stop it? To look nice, your foundation has to form a thin film on your skin that's flexible and doesn't get disturbed by sweat and face oil. But it also has to feel comfortable while it's on your skin. It's a bit tricky to predict exactly when a foundation will clump up when you layer it with other products. A general rule is that it'll happen when the outer phases of their formulas don't match. Let's say we use a water in silicone product under a water in silicone foundation. The outer phases are silicone, and since silicones mix with silicones well, the outer phases will mix nicely, and the water droplets should mostly stay separate, and so you end up with a nice blend. You might still get some disturbance, but it should still mostly look normal. But say instead you use a silicone in water product, and then immediately put a water in silicone foundation on top. This time, the outer phases don't match. The water and the silicone in the outer phases don't like each other, and so they'll repel. You'll end up with patchy clumping instead of a continuous, even layer of foundation. And so the safest thing to do is to match the outer phases. So how do you know what the outer phase is? The outer phase is often called the base, but I think that's a little bit confusing. And that's because you don't always have more of the outer phase. In my mayonnaise, for example, the outer phase is water, even though the recipe has about 5 times as much oil. That's because the quantity of the ingredients isn't what tells you what becomes the outer phase. It's the way you mix it together and the emulsifiers used. I poured the oil into the vinegar, and so the vinegar stayed on the outside. Unfortunately, we don't have hidden cameras in cosmetic factories yet, so we'll have to make an educated guess instead. For foundations, almost all liquid foundations that you'll find in stores these days are water in silicone emulsions. If the ingredients list has silicones in the top 4 ingredients, it's almost guaranteed that it's a water in silicone emulsion. You're looking for ingredients that end in cone or siloxane. Remember that since the inner phase can have more stuff than the outer phase, water can still be above silicones in the ingredients list. Common silicones you'll find in foundations are cyclopentasiloxane, dimethicone, and phenyltrimethicone. If there aren't any silicones near the top of the ingredients list, the main way you can tell is from the texture of the foundation. Oil and water emulsions are usually runnier. If it's a thick cream or if it's solid, it's probably water and oil. This still isn't an exact way of telling, but it will give you a guide. For everything else, like primers and moisturizers, there isn't really an overwhelmingly popular type of emulsion, unlike from foundations, and you can't tell from the ingredients list. But here are some things that might point you in the right direction. If you look at the texture of the product, oil and water emulsions are usually runnier, and they sink into your skin faster. Water and oil emulsions are usually thicker and richer, but silicones can blur the lines here. You can also look at what happens when you wet the product with water. If it feels really greasy when you're trying to wash it off your hands with just water, the outer phase is probably oil or silicone. The type of product it is can also give you a clue. Some products will use a particular emulsion type more often. Primers usually have silicone or water as the outer phase. Thin moisturizers usually have water as the outer phase. Thick moisturizers usually have oil as the outer phase. Waterproof sunscreens are usually water in oil or water in silicone. But these still aren't absolute ways of testing it. The best way is probably to test the conductivity of the emulsion. Since water conducts electricity, but silicones and oils don't, the emulsion will only conduct if water is the outer or continuous phase. Sometimes, even making sure the outer phases match won't entirely prevent clumping. Some products are designed so that the emulsion breaks really easily when it's applied, and so the structure doesn't stay the same after you've applied it. Sometimes, oils just don't mix with silicones. Your skin also produces oil throughout the day, as you're wearing your foundation, and so this extra oil can also disrupt your foundation film. So what else can you do? Even after you've analyzed your products and you're doing all the right things, if it clumps, there are still a few more things you can try. Firstly, you should test the product combination out on your skin before you plan to use it. This is pretty obvious, but there's no substitute for testing the products that you're actually planning to combine on your arm or on your face when you're not rushing to get somewhere on time. You can also wait in between layers of product. When you're applying an emulsion product, as you rub it in, a lot of the droplets will end up merging together, and so you end up with layers on your skin. The water can then evaporate into the air or absorb into your skin. And so this means you're left mostly with just oil on your skin. And so if you put other products with oil or silicone as the outer phase on top, like your standard foundation, it won't repel as much. If you try to apply one of these products before the water on top evaporates, you might still get some repulsion. You can also try using less product underneath. So there's a better chance that it'll sink into your skin, and so there's less repulsion. Using a thicker foundation can help as well. Thicker foundations are usually more stable, and so they won't move around on your skin as much and break up. You can also try using a setting spray. When a setting spray dries, the polymers in them turn into a clear film that helps hold the foundation in place, and so it can't move around as much and clump up. You can also try applying a light layer of powder before your foundation, which is also called the Wayne Goss method. The powder can soak up any extra oil that your skin produces before it makes it up and reaches your foundation. None of these methods are guaranteed to work, but they can help. So I hoped you liked this video since it is a little bit different from my usual skincare videos. You can leave me a comment and let me know what other makeup signs you want me to talk about. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. You can also follow me on Instagram and check out my blog for more beauty science. See you next time.